Hi all, in this video, we'll learn how to scan and fix the security issues in our project. So this is a sample React.js project. So not only React.js project, if it is Angular, Vue, or any of the projects which has package JSON file and all the dependencies are declared like this, it's good to do the security scan test on this. So we need to scan all these third-party dependencies. Why to scan the dependencies, dev dependencies, optional dependencies means these are third-party dependencies where this code is open source, and with the help of this code, hackers may enter into the application and they can do a huge loss for us. So these are the reasons we need to do a security scan before going to the production environment, because this causes a loss for us to the business and the production environment as well. So we need to do a security scan for all these third-party dependencies. And we need to find what all the issues are there, security issues are there in these third-party dependencies. So thereafter, we'll show you how to fix them. So before going to that, whenever we have npm package.json file, we'll be doing that npm install. I've taken this from the Git repo, this project. So now, to run to work on this project, I need to do npm install. So let me do that. npm I. So npm install and npm I both are the same. So once you do npm I, it installs all the dependencies. And finally, it will automatically run npm audit as well. npm audit will run and it will give the report. So to have npm audit, we need to have npm version 6. Because npm audit is available from 6.x version. So from this version, 6.x version only, npm audit is available. So if you have lower versions, then please update your npm version to the latest. So this is a command for that. So I'm providing you npm install npm at the rate latest hyphen g. Hyphen g stands for the globally. We are trying to install npm globally so that you will be getting the latest version of 6. So that you can use npm audit. So fine. So I have taken a new project, npm I. I am installing all the dependencies. Once it installs all the dependencies, it will provide us npm audit. Under the hood, what happens? Npm will be installing all the dependencies one by one. And it will check in the npm registry whether this dependency has any security threats or not. If there are any security threats, it will provide us the npm audit as well. So let me show you that. I will directly run the npm audit. So if you run npm audit, it will show list of options like this. Now we got npm audit. So these are the four. If you can observe here, there are four security threats. Two are low, two are high. Here there would be four security levels. Severity levels. High and critical issues, security issues should be fixed as soon as possible. But as coming to the low and moderate can be fixed when in the next releases, or we can take some time to fix them. So there would be four security threats. So as we got two high issues, we need to address it as soon as possible. So now check, we have four security issues. From four, three of them require a semantic versioning major dependency update. So what does it mean? So let's check that. So, and the another one is, it is saying that it needs a manual review. So let's check both of them. So if you go to the top, so the issues would be in this manner. This is one of the issue. As we have four issues, two are high and two are low. The high issues here, it will provide the security, severity level and the cause of the issue, remote code execution. Where this security, where this issue is present means in this package, serialized JavaScript. In this package, we got an issue, security threat is there. But this package was not directly installed by us. We have installed React scripts. From this React scripts, this package was came. You can find the path here. We have installed only React scripts. React scripts is dependent upon this Webpack plugin, and this Webpack plugin is dependent upon this serialized JavaScript. So this is the reason we got this issue, and this is saying the dependency on this. So like this, you can understand, you can scan the project. So This is how we are going to scan. So the first step of scanning the project was done. Now you need to analyze what all the issues and what all the fixes. So if you go to the top, it is showing NPM audit security report, and you can see here, run this command. NPM will provide us maximum help to resolve all the security issues. It is asking us to install React scripts to 4.0 version so that 3 security threats would be resolved. It is giving a hint for us, but it is saying that there would be a potentially there are breaking changes. Why this is warning us this? Because here in the React scripts, we have 3.4.1 version. In this version, we have issue. It is asking us to move to 4.0.1 version. Here we know in the semantic versioning, first would be the major release, second one is minor release, and third one is a patch. As from 3 major version, we are shifting to the 4 major version. It is warning us whether it would be breaking changes. So we need to check. Don't install security issues. Don't try to resolve multiple security issues at a time, because all these security issues may resolve some breaking issues where your project may not work, where your application may not work as earlier. So resolve each security issue at a time and test your application once again, whether there are any breaking changes or not. In that way, it is very good to track all the system, all the application flow as well. Here there is more information tab also. Let me show it. Control click. So it will open in the browser. So there are some more information and some advices as well, how to resolve this. So he will give certain description why this is an attack, and here he will give a solution to upgrade to 3.1.0 or later. So these are the hints. You need to understand whether this is really an issue for you, or it occurs only to particular operating system or in particular domain like that. So here the solution is we need to upgrade to 3.1.0. Also, you can see the versions tab. So it is showing what are all the affected versions. So all these versions, if anyone are using any of these versions, this security threat would be there for them. So these are the unaffected versions. So we need to use one of these versions according to our project dependency, such that our project should not break. So try using unaffected versions. So let's go back here. So this is how you need to analyze your security issues. So you can also do NPM audit fix, where NPM will help us to fix any of the automatically fixed issues. If there are any small issues, it would be fixed automatically. So we need to do NPM audit fix for that. So never do NPM audit fix force. Let me show you. So this is a warning he's throwing. NPM audit fix -- force. So if you do this, it will try to forcefully install all the dependencies. Even those are major dependencies as well, it will install, where the breaking changes may occur and your application may not work as earlier. So don't do NPM fix -- force anytime. So try to do the suggestion what he has given. So this is a suggestion it was given. NPM is asking to install us React scripts to the latest version. So let's do that. NPM install React scripts to the latest version -s. So to install this, I means I stands here for the install, and -s means I'm installing this dependency under dependencies. -d, capital D, means dev dependencies. We are asking to install in the dev dependencies. Here -S means we are asking to React scripts to install in the dependencies. So now we could able to install React scripts latest. So you can check all the 3 issues would be gone. Here we have 4 issues. As we are updating to the major updates, 3 issues would be gone. In 3 issues, 2 are the high issues. So now we would be having only one lawyer issue. So this is how we need to fix. So most of the cases, all the security issues will have two fixes. So in the way we need to fix are two things. Number one would be upgrading the version. And the number two is finding a best alternative and moving to that. If you can't fix, or if there is no fix in that part for that particular package, then it's better to find an alternative, or you can raise and pull request in the GitHub for the particular package as well. We have that option as well. So let me show you this once it is done. So meanwhile, I will show you how to manually. This is a manual review. So it is asking us to manually review this dependency because it is unable to take a decision on this security threat. It is not able to give an advice on this. So for that, you have a few options. So it is showing an issue in node fetch. Okay. Let me show you once it is fixed. Yep. Now it was fixed. So we have only found one lower severity issue. So let's get that report. To get the report, you need to run NPM audit. Now you will be getting one lower issue. Yep, we got one. So it will clearly mention like this, manual review. It means it is not able to take an action to resolve this dependency. So now we need to take an action on this. So as I said, in the issue severity is low. This is because of DOS attack. This security threat is present in node fetch. These are the possible updates. So it is saying the patch is available in the below updates. So from where this issue is coming means it is coming from the React Google Maps. So this is a path. This is a main path, React Google Maps, where this map is all these are the dependency libraries for this map. So it is exist in the node fetch. Issue is exist in the node fetch. So try to open this command. So it will give more information on the particular security issue. We can read this. So few of the issues. So this is a fix, it is saying. So you can fix, means you can upgrade to the next level. Or the second option is, if you are not able to find any of the fix for this, you need to find the best alternative. So for that, you can go to the same website and you can find alternatives for that. For example, if there is some issue in the QR code package which you are using. So you can go to the N number of QR code packages with the quality. So you can filter here the quality, popularity, and maintenance. So we need to go to the quality. I'm sorting by quality. So the most popular quality, there won't be any security, less security issues. So those comes to the top. So you need to find the best alternative for that. And you can use that library in place of a security threat library. Yep, in that way, you need to manually review each and everything. In some cases, you need to upgrade the immediate library. Like if there is no solution to upgrade to the node fetch, there is an option to update isomorphic fetch package such that this issue may fix automatically. If not, you can also update FBJS as well. So here in this website, he has been provided these options. So if there is a package and the dependent package with the vulnerabilities, so you can update the dependent package here. So he's asking to update this to fix this manual review security issues as well. So the one more option we have. So this is regarding NPM audit, how to scan, how to fix. So one more we have is retry. Like NPM install, I'm trying to install globally, retire. So this is another package. So it scans for the more security issues than what NPM does. So just run in retire in the project which you are there. So it will give a number of issues, same as NPM audit, with the high severity and issue number and why the issue was happened. So also he will be providing the fix as well in the GitHub link. Will be providing the GitHub link. So let's check this. There is an issue with the jQuery 3.2.1. So he's asking us to migrate to the fix is available in 3.5.0, it seems. So we are using 3.2. 1 here. So he's asking us to migrate from 3.2.1 to 3.5.0, where this security issue has an fix. In 3.2.1, he is mentioning that there is an chance of cross-site scripting. Here he is mentioned. There is a chance of cross-site scripting. So that's the reason he's asking us to upgrade. So you can also install Retire to check for more security issues. It is also same as what we have done for NPM audit. Also, security issues means not fixing once. You need to keep this NPM audit in your continuous integration and deployment lifecycle as well. Because day by day, the security issues would be coming and the patches would be coming at the same time. We need to update our packages to make sure that we don't expose our code to the security threats and we are up to date with all the packages, security packages. So that's the way we will be safe. So this is all about the how to scan and how to fix, how to analyze the security issues. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.